have children, and she also adopted a few kids, right?
She adopted three, and then her lover had one. So we have four together now.
And her lover is just a magnificent
person. What's her name again?
Kelly.
Kelly, yeah, Kelly. She's precious.
And she's a good businesswoman. She had this business before she met Rosie.
Before she met Rosie, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so Rosie just complements it and brings the entertainment. Mm-hmm. The entertainment came from New York, and it was just ace number one entertainment.
Wow, it's great.
Just a fabulous shows. Mm-hmm. And Rosie is just, you know, she makes herself, she's accessible, and she's a real person.
Beautiful. And I think she helps just about anybody who gets to her. I really believe she tries.
She gave away cars. She did amazing things on
the trip.
And the people who need them. And, you know, she makes sure the people who need things get them.
It's beautiful.
It was such a meaningful, important trip in the lives of the people who attended, because a lot of folks brought their parents and their grandparents and their children, of course.
It was like coming out then?
Well, no.
It's like more like a celebration party, something.
It was an opportunity for families to be together with each other and have fun together in an environment that was totally accepting and supportive. And then also, there were so many events for the young people. I mean, how many children were aboard?
800 children.
800 children.
Very atypical of a cruise.
Were their grandparents there with grandchildren?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, that's
did they bring their pets, everything?
Children, no.
No pets.
No pets. Just children. But they had activities for, can you imagine all these kids who have gay children, who have gay parents, children of gay parents, the teenagers get to interact with each other and have that those friendships with other kids of gay parents.
They can bond and bond.
And
bond.
That don't happen often.
It was just wonderful for them.
Wow, and that do not happen often at all.
Oh, no.
You know, so she's about the first person.
Alaska.
Alaska.
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
Oh. Are the icebergs depleting as we speak?
Yes.
Yeah, they are.
Global warming is here.
That's great. Yeah. So what's your next trip?
Well, now we have this property in near Santa Fe, New Mexico, in Pecos, New Mexico.
Okay.
That's where all our trips are going to be.
Beautiful.
You're going to build a home there?
Oh, yes. Yes. Have you ever heard of Chris Williamson?
Yes.
Well, she's going to be living there, too.
So we've heard. That's a rumor.
Oh. But yeah. She's a good friend of the developer.
Really? That's great. Well, how long has this development been in process?
Well, this
about 5 years?
Yeah, just a few years. This is phase one. We're catching the tail end of phase one, and then phase two, they'll open up a bunch more lots. And then there's a community center and a assisted living facility in the plan.
Those are in the plans.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's just for gay couples, I guess?
No.
Anyone can live there?
Anyone
Maybe
can live there.
We ought to buy a lot.
Yes.
You just have to be, accepting of the people who are going to be living there.
Because that's the predominant
That's
population.
What we all should be, is accepting of others.
And it's also not just women, by the way. I shouldn't have said that.
Okay. Men as well, too.
Yeah. Males as well. That's good. That is very good.
There's this adorable gay couple there, and they just started building their home. So when we go out there in, May? There should be finished, so we should be able to see it.
I know, it's a beautiful home, isn't it?
They're called casitas. They're one floor, two-bedroom homes, and they're beautiful. They're absolutely beautiful. And, you know, the more my knees hurt, the more I think I'm going
to
love being on one floor.
Yes. You don't have to worry about going up and down the stairs or anything like that. You'll be on one level floor, which would make a difference. Can you mention something, any marriage in the plans or anything for the future?
Sure.
We get married everywhere we can go.
We've done several commitment ceremonies.
What was your first one?
What was the first one?
The Lincoln Memorial one?
No, the one at Gay Pride in D.C., the minister. We have that photo of that.
Yeah.
But then for the Millennium, 2000, they had a Millennium March, a Gay Pride March called Millennium March. And there was a mass gay marriage on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial.
That was in D.C.?
Thousands of people.
Oh, yeah? Okay. Mm-hmm.
People came in gowns. It was just tuxedos.
Oh, wow.
It was magnificent. It was so touching. You just cried the whole time. It was just amazing.
Was this an all-day long event?
No, it was just
a few hours early in the morning. Yeah.
And Troy Perry, I believe, the head of MCC, Metropolitan Community Church, led the ceremony, and there were speakers, and it was just fabulous.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Must have had a beautiful time.
It beautiful weather. It was just.
I have some family in Toronto, so we talk about going up there to get married, and then but mostly we want to wait for the state of Maryland if we can.
Are you originally from?
Yeah, we both are. Yeah,
Okay. New York is. New York or
from here?
Here. Okay. Here
Baltimore and Baltimore? Silver Spring.
Baltimore and Silver Spring.
Okay. Wow.
Do you have any pets? I guess not. You want to try?
Oh, yes. We have cats.
I do too.
How many?
How many you got?
Two.
Two fabulous Tonkinese babies.
Oh, I got three. I've got three of them.
And how old are they?
They were just a year old, and they're incredible. They're incredible. They're the most amazing.
Say what
animals.
Tonkinese is.
Tonkinese are half Siamese and half Burmese, and they're just gorgeous, and they don't have a lot of the problems of inbreeding. They're smart. The Siamese are so smart, and they have the small noses that the Burmese have. And they're beautiful. They're beautiful, and the funny thing is their tails go from
they curl
the back
up.
And they curl all the way up to the tops of their heads.
God.
We've never seen anything like
a monkey?
That before.
Yeah, sort of.
Seriously.
Like a monkey
tail?
Well, I mean, not all the time, but they can make them do that.
But they're adorable, aren't they?
Yeah.
Oh, how long have you had them for?
A year.
Whole time.
About a year.
Yeah, well,
we got them
minus
when they were
3 months.
8 weeks old.
Yeah.
Little babies.
Who does the cooking in your house? I have to know about the cooking. Who cooks?
Well, Ruth is a gourmet cook.
You used to?
But she's not well enough. Yeah.
What was your favorite dish?
Oh my heavens.
Tell me the best dish you ever made in your life.
Every dish.
Well, I have actually one that was on my mind was it was a low carb dish. It was chicken in a sour cream and green peppercorn sauce.
Ooh, that sounds good.
Just absolutely magnificent. It was out of one of the low carb cookbooks. And whenever there was a special occasion, Nina would come home to that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you bring flowers to one another?
Oh, sure.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so nice. How about a little card? I love you occasionally. I love cards.
Absolutely. Yeah.
E-cards.
See, those are great.
She sent me one that where you can record the voice, and there were these little kitties talking to me one day. It was great.
It sounds really great.
I met her right after her 50th birthday. And she didn't have a good time when she turned 50. She was in a bad relationship, and it was this very unhappy time for her. So I sent her roses for her 50th birthday. Several months later.
Beautiful, beautiful yellow roses.
Yeah.
I love yellow roses. I really, really do. They're beautiful.
It's wonderful. It is.
But that's one of the nice things about being partnered with a woman is that
you know their feelings.
Well, we both give each other flowers all the time.
That's good, because a man really thinks about it.
We love to shop.
Are we shoppers? Oh, my heavens.
Yes.
No, well, we spend a lot of money, but we do it together.
Oh, that's good. Okay. Who handles the money? Who handles the bankroll?
We both do.
That's good, so you're equally together. Okay. But one of you doesn't buy something without the other one knowing it. For surprises, but not just going to shopping with
Marie. No, she bought a state-of-the-art cell phone a few years ago, and I was so furious with her for making that. And within a day, we had bought a second one for me.
That is so beautiful. Everything works out in life. For the both of you all, I really do.
Well, we're looking. The thing that's really neat about getting this land is this just gives us another adventure.
Yes, exactly.
And we feel renewed.
Well, say something for Rosie because she's going to get a copy of this tape next week. Say something. What would you like to say to Rosie O'Donnell? Nina, you first.
Well,
because we're going to wrap up here in just a few seconds. So
I want to say something about her book that I read. And I just wanted to tell her that I really liked reading her book, which I can't even think of the name of at the moment.
What would you like to say to Rosie?
I think that she is a beautiful, beautiful soul.
She is. Okay. Well, we've come to the end of our show. I'd like to be here for another couple of hours, but we're going to have to say adios for tonight. Until next time. Adios, everybody.